Well, we may be looking at a situation where next month at Halloween Havoc, the Warrior may be challenging Goldberg for the World's Heavyweight title.
What a contest that would be if Warrior can survive tomorrow night at Fall Brawl featuring the War Games. It will be Goldberg and Warrior at Halloween Havoc from Vegas next month on pay-per-view.
But realistically, that's just one of nine possibilities.
Oh, yeah.
Because Fall Brawl and the War Games, that event, but really just unlimited potential and unlimited possibilities when you look at the wrestlers that are involved inside the double ring, double steel cage.
Who will face Goldberg at Halloween Havoc? The only way to find out is to call your cable company or satellite provider and tell them I gotta have Fall Brawl 98 featuring the War Games tomorrow night.
But Scott, that is not the only confrontation among the warring factions of the NWO at Fall Brawl. J.J. Dillon made it official this past Thursday on Thunder. Conan, representing the NWO Wolfpack, will face the returning Scott Hall of the NWO Black and White, and Scott Hall made quite an auspicious return on Thunder.
Oh yeah, no question about it. Certainly one for the record books from Scott Hall last Thursday in Lexington. The gentlemen, Chris Adams and Jerry Flynn, set to square off here on WCW Saturday night. Of course, Chris Adams, the master of the super kick, but Jerry Flynn knows how to throw a kick himself.
Scott, we were just talking about Halloween Havoc and the winner of the War Games going on to face the Warrior for the World's Heavyweight title. Well, tickets are available in Las Vegas, Nevada for Halloween Havoc on October 25th. And those tickets are available right now at the MGM Grand Garden box office, as well as all Ticketmaster outlets.
What a night it's going to be at the Grand Garden Arena in Vegas. Not your hometown, but your adopted hometown, I guess.
Right, and it's almost a tradition at this point. When you think of Halloween Havoc, you think of the MGM Grand Garden Arena and Las Vegas, Nevada.
And the big cookout at Mike Today's house the afternoon before the pay-per-view.
You're going to be there.
Oh, I'm there. Are you kidding me? Armbar by Chris Adams on Jerry Flynn. Adams now taking it up to the second rope, still barring the arm. Is he going to drop across the shoulder? No, Billy Silverman breaks it up. Oh, spinning back kick caught Adams right in the breadbasket.
Well, Chris Adams had that eye contact with the referee, Billy Silverman, and it was just that momentary distraction that really opened the door for Jerry Flynn, and he takes advantage in the corner.
Series of front kicks, and then that great extension by a very tall man, and Jerry Flynn shoots Adams across, charges in. Adams sidesteps it, go behind, belly to back, suplex by the gentleman, Chris Adams.
You know, in Jerry Flynn, we're looking at a wrestler who can beat you in so many different ways as we see Chris Adams go to the rear mount. Big forearm smash delivered to the back of the head.
And once again,
very smartly, Jerry Flynn makes that contact with the bottom rope, the safety of the rope break. Nice double leg takedown.
Now into the front mount by Jerry Flynn, reining in the forearms on Chris Adams. Adams tries to go into the guard. Flynn, nice escape, into a lateral press.
We were talking about the multi-dimensional attack of Jerry Flynn, and there's really a prime example. He can beat you with kicks, and he can beat you with submission holds as he stakes out the arm, extending the arm and trying to work over the elbow and the wrist of Adams, drops down with a knee.
That's a great way to hyperextend an elbow in there, as Jerry Flynn really has Chris Adams in a bad way. Oh, knife-edge chop across the chest by Jerry Flynn on the gentleman, Chris Adams. Adams needs to get untracked here.
Now, Jerry Flynn just continues the assault, throttling Chris Adams while he's hooked up against the ropes.
Flynn throttling him in the corner now, knee into the gut of Chris Adams.
You make a good point. Chris Adams has really failed to get really untracked in this matchup at all.
Reversal, Adams.
That may be it. That may get him on track.
The clothesline right under the chin of Jerry Flynn. Now, belly-to-belly suplex by Chris Adams, lateral press. Good weight distribution, but Flynn not quite softened up enough.
Looks like he's gonna try and set him up for a power bomb or a pile driver. What's it gonna be?
The pile driver.
But did you see Flynn?
Yeah.
It looked like Flynn blocked the move.
Flynn got his shoulders up over the thighs of Chris Adams just before impact.
Yeah, that
nice
move
block.
Did not really hit with full impact. When Flynn's head made contact with the mat, he was able to partially block it.
Oh, but Flynn shot into the corner now by Chris Adams. It softened up Flynn enough. Oh, look at this. Forearm for
across the jaw. Oh, and he's laying him in there. Just listen to that.
Oh, the impact.
Flesh on flesh.
Flynn, that's just instinct. Just shoves Adams off. Adams hit hard in the center of the ring, but Flynn has been rocked.
To try and clear the cobwebs here. Hey, Adams left the arm unprotected, and there it is. He's got him hooked with the cross arm bar.
He did it.
He tapped out. Submission win for Jerry Flynn. And that was really an impressive fashion. The cross arm bar, and Jerry Flynn scores the victory over Chris Adams on Saturday night.